Hi, I'm Jamie Willis-Rose, and this is my PowerApps tutorial video on my animated clock app. This is part one, where I'll show you what the app does. Later, part two, I'll get into how the app works. So the objective for this app was to create a, quote, analog clock. My clock should update in real time. It'll show the hours, minutes, and seconds. And my other requirement was that it could only use PowerApps, no external data sources or connections. But why, you ask? Why am I doing this? Well, I'm sure there are other ways to do this, better ways, but again, I don't imagine this to be a practical application as is. I just wanted to have a fun challenge, so hopefully you'll take it as that and maybe learn something. I certainly learned a lot doing this. Okay, so let's take a look at my app. Just note that I'm going to demo all the features first, and then in part two, I will go over how the app works. If there's anything specifically that you want me to go over in more detail, let me know. And of course, I'll post the app on where everyone can download it on the community forum. Okay, so next, let's take a look at these large XY sliders. Over on the left here, we have the Y slider. If we move this up, it moves the clock up. If we move it down, it moves the clock down. And notice that the hour, minute, and second hands stay in sync as I move it. More on how that happens in part two. So by default, the clock defaults to the user's current local time, which in my case is Eastern Standard Time or UTC minus 5. I've added a slider control to allow users to change the hour by simply sliding the control back and forth. As you can see, the slider indicates what hour the offset is. So I'm offsetting it by 19 here, I'm offsetting it here by 9, and the hour hand, I know it's a circle, but I'm calling it a hand, moves around the circle as I adjust. And if I go to 12, it goes right back to where it started. Next, let's toggle the smooth second hand animation toggle here. So if I come over here and I toggle this, pay attention to this little blue, the smallest blue hand. Again, I know it's a circle. When I toggle it, you'll notice it changes. Now you can see it's a smoother animation as it goes around the circle. So with it off, and you have the more classic tick-tock that you're more familiar with than the analog clock. But with it on, it's a more smoother animation. I'll explain more in part two how that works. Next, let's talk about the last feature here, the debug mode. This is something that I like to add to all of my apps. It's a toggle that allows me to show and hide controls that aren't necessarily going to be in production, but I need for development. So if you're developing an app and you want to have access to variables and collections and other things right there on the screen while you're developing the app, I recommend something like this so you can kind of easily see what's happening in the app. So what I've done here is if I toggle this on, you'll see a gallery appears with the variables and controls here on the left. Then I've also, just for the heck of it, I put the formulas in here. These are just text boxes. And then over here, the actual current values. And then this gallery refreshes every 60 seconds. Or you can manually refresh it. And we've got the current time, the hour hand, the minute hand, the second hand, and then the second hand smooth animation down here. And as I said, it will refresh every 60 seconds here. So just wait for it. It should refresh here and boom, like that. So that is my app. So I'm going to stop here and create a second video with all the nitty gritty. If you want to learn how the app worked, I'll post the app to the PowerApps community forum so you can play with it, download it. If you have any questions, you can find me on Twitter at @JWillisRose or on LinkedIn, also on the community forum. So look forward to getting your feedback and stay tuned for part two. Thanks.